Hi guys, this is Nina here. I've got Spirit here. He's my black lab, and Hannah's in the background. She's my chocolate. And I want to talk to you guys about muzzle training your dog. This is a fun game that you can do. I think that every dog should at least be muzzle trained. Spirit, you goofball. Because they will most likely be muzzled at some point in their life, whether it's going to the vet, if they're injured, and, you need to keep their weapon, which is their mouth, closed so that you can actually help the dog. Also, animal control officers may use a muzzle if they find your dog is a stray. In any natural disaster, there's a good possibility that your dog will end up being muzzled. So I think it's just really important to get them used to putting their nose in something. And you can think of it as a face mask. Just like we have to wear face masks now, think about how long it took to be comfortable with that. Takes dogs just as long to get comfortable wearing a muzzle. It doesn't mean your dog is a bad dog. It doesn't mean your dog is a vicious dog, although people do muzzle their dogs for those reasons. Think of police officers. Their canine companions are muzzled for safety reasons. Dogs eat inappropriate things. You may see dogs muzzled because they're eating poop, or they're eating mushrooms, or they're eating rocks and their teeth are breaking. If they've had dental surgery, and you need to keep them from eating sticks. So muzzles can be a really, really handy tool. And it's really not that difficult to muzzle train a dog. So just a brief overview on what a muzzle looks like if you guys have never seen one. This is an Italian basket muzzle. You can see that it has the long sides here that go all the way up into where the dog's ear is, and then there's a strap around it that attaches behind their head, behind their ears, to keep it on. This one is great for long-snouted dogs. All my labs have worn them. They're very comfortable for them. They can pant openly. They can get treats through it. They can drink water. They can run for hours, and they can play with them. They learn very quickly how to adapt to pushing a ball around or, that kind of thing. This is also a version of the basket muzzle. This is a Baskerville. You can see that it's not as long for the nose area here. It's also wider in the back, so it fits over where it meets the bridge of the nose. It also has wider openings here, so that you can feed very readily through it. Dogs also can pick up things with this one, where with the other one they can't. So it just depends on what you're trying to prevent. The type of muzzle that they use at groomers and at vets, veterinarian offices, are the mesh muzzles. As you can see, it's got a really narrow opening for your dog's snout. And it really actually works as keeping their mouth closed rather than allowing them to open their mouth. These are more for protective reasons, whether your dog is dog reactive or will attack bicycles or joggers. Hannah does that, so that's why she's muzzled whenever I have her out. She's also dog reactive. So this just keeps everybody safe. Also, if you do have a reactive dog, you don't want the dog recoiling on you out of frustration. And that's another topic that we can go through. If you guys want to ask questions about that, I'd be more than happy to answer you. But to start muzzle training, it's actually really simple. You guys can use, a wider mouth Tupperware container, as your dog gets better with it. This is like a Dixie, treat cup. Or you can use a drinking cup. A solo cup works great. You don't want the real tall ones that you would drink beer out of necessarily. You might want to have to cut it down so that your dog can actually get, their nose into it. And to start out, this is a larger, Ziploc container that has a top on it, so you can see how wide that is. So what I'm going to do, and we'll see who comes first, because, hey, I got food in my pocket, and they're labs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop a couple treats. Actually, this is their dinner kibble, into the container, and I'm going to see who wants it. Here, Spirit. We'll get Spirit to come. He's pretty good with this. So I'm going to, hopefully you guys can see, I'm going to put it down on the floor, and he's going to stick his face in there, and I'm going to say yes and treat him. This way, you guys, he's sticking his nose in. You want to reinforce the nose going in. If he gets the treats, that's self-rewarding. That's a good thing. But I'm just going to drop it in. He puts his nose in. I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to treat him. Okay. And you guys can practice this as much as you can, and excuse the video thing. This is my first time doing this. If your dog is a smaller snout, is not a lab, you know, is like a Bichon or a Dachshund or something like that, you're not certainly going to use a big container. You want to be appropriate with the size of your dog. You know, if you have a pug, you're not going to have, well, you may need a bigger one. But play with it. Find out what works. So you can do this repeatedly, and I suggest you have different size containers. You know, this is a large one. I'm starting with the large one. I am now going to move to the little cup container. I'm dropping food in here, and I'm going to put it in front of Spirit. And he's going to stick his nose in. He's all the way in, which is great. I'm going to mark him with a yes and reward him for that. This is more like putting his face in a muzzle, actually, because it's a little bit narrow and it's a little bit deeper. So we'll try it again. He's putting his nose in. Nope. He's going to do the paw. Hannah, you want to try? So here's Hannah. She's going all the way in. So I'm going to mark her with that. Yes, good girl. And your dog will pick up really quickly on this because you're rewarding, you're reinforcing the nose going actually into something. So, yes. Even if they just stick the top of their nose in there, they don't necessarily have to go all the way down to begin with. The other thing you could do, and if you were actually, you know, physically training with a muzzle, is you could put peanut butter. This is how I muzzle trained my first lab, Tucker, is I actually put peanut butter. It was kind of messy, but it served the purpose of getting his face in there, is putting peanut butter on the inside of the muzzle. You can put cheese. You can actually use butter. That way your dog is actually in there, and they're taking their time licking the peanut butter off, which is actually getting them used to having their face and their nose in there for a long period of time. So I'm going to see if we can get Hannah to put her face in the muzzle. I don't have the strap on. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put the food in the muzzle. And I'm going to ask her, Hannah, come. Okay. I'm going to ask her to go all the way in. See, she's all the way in. I got to move the camera down so you can actually see what she's doing. See how she's in? She's actually being reinforced because the treats are in there. So I'll do it again. Hannah. Yeah. Go in. Yes. Now, when your dog has their face in the muzzle, actually, one of the faculty members at Victoria Stola's Dog Training Academy, which is where I went to learn how to become a dog trainer, his dog is muzzle trained. He wears it for anxiety reasons. And he calls it elephant. So when your dog is sticking their nose in a cup or a muzzle, you can, once they get used to doing it, and they're doing it reliably, then you can say elephant or banana or whatever it is that you want to call it. That way it's a cue. It's like telling your dog to sit. That's a verbal cue. So have fun with it. Let me know how it goes. And if you have any questions or you guys want more in-depth training on muzzles and how they're fit, that kind of thing, There are also a lot of really good resources out there for muzzle training your dog. There's called the Muzzle Up Project. And it's becoming more and more, you know, popular. I don't want to say popular in that, you know, everybody's doing it. But you'll see more and more dogs muzzled for many different reasons. If you see a dog muzzled, just give the dog a little bit more space. And have fun with it. Take care, guys. Bye.